How much do you pay for rent? How much do you guys pay for rent in New York? How much do you pay for rent in New York?
Do I have to tell you?
Can I have a tour of your apartment?
Yeah, why not?
There is one rule.
How much do you guys pay for rent in New York?
Seems like a nice place.
I said, oh, shit.
How much you pay for rent here? How much do you pay for rent?
So what we got here?
So this is Thumper and Monkey's closet. Basically, my closet turned into a cat closet. And with her special needs, I basically decked it out in blankets and towels and whatnot, pillowcases.
Yeah, it looks dope.
Thank you.
You have a whole fan up there too.
Yeah, so it helps keep the air circulating, especially if it's been a long morning. It might be one or two stinkies in here. Make sure that it doesn't just
makes sense.
Yeah. Their food, her little laxatives to help her go.
What are all these little notes that you have on?
So those are my notes for any babysitters or kitty sitters that come by.
Wow! How you doing, little buddy?
It helps.
Hi, Dumper, gay lady, little pretty lady.
They got beds on beds on beds here, too.
Oh, yeah. Keeps right them there, clean. Right that there. Way, if one gets dirty during the night, they have more spaces to be. I just flip them every other day, do some laundry, and honestly, doesn't even faze me. Pretty easy, pretty seamless. Just a matter of getting in the routine. Saves her life, saves their lives, and I'm okay with that.
What's your name and why did you start fostering cats?
So, hi, I'm Alexa Sanchez, and I started fostering cats about right when the pandemic started. Quarantine had just came around, and I'd actually been seeing a lot of posts on social media from our local animal shelters saying that there was a lot of kitties in need. And I remember thinking, well, I guess I have the time now and the resources. Let's see what we can do. So I did a little research, and I noticed that you honestly don't really need much to start fostering, just like a spare bathroom or a closet, just about, you know, getting creative with your space. So I started fostering. First was with APA, Awesome Pets Alive, an awesome, awesome shelter here in Austin, Texas, and immediately decided, if I'm going to do this, let's help the ones that really need it. So I started focusing on the special needs, both physical and behavioral kitties, the ones that, you know, we get passed around a lot, maybe overseen, and just started fostering them because I realized that fostering, at least for the level that Austin has gotten to be their top-notch no-kill city, is due to fostering. And with more people on hand to actually bring in those pets, more the shelters can bring in the pets that need extra help. So I thought this is a great way to give back to my community with a little bit of love and a whole lot of cuddles.
Why do you keep doing this?
Well, short answer, there's always a kitty in need. Long answer, I think it stems from a sense that as a human, we all, in a way, contribute to overpopulation and the crisis in shelters, regardless if you have bought from a pet or adopted from a shelter or anything like that. The lack of resources and general mindset that goes into animals and their care all across the country and the world definitely contributes to how often they're neglected, overlooked, hurt, and put on red lists just because they got a little cold or something happened in their family life and they happened to end up at the shelter. So feeling that and knowing that, I thought, if I have a little bit of space and a little bit of time, saving a life is awesome and I'll keep doing it for sure. There's always a kitty.
What is something you wish the world would know?
Ooh, that's a good question. I think, of course, I feel like I would have to say fostering saves lives, but I don't want it to go over because that's so heard. But what I want to say is your feelings of thinking it'll be too hard to let go because you can get attached very easily are valid. It's definitely very valid. But because you have those feelings, I think that makes it your superpower because you are not only willing and able, but if you understand that the goal is goodbye and the goal has always been goodbye, the satisfaction and love that you get from knowing they understood you were there to help and they understand that they're going to be in their forever home safe and happy because you just had a little extra patience and time in your day makes all the difference. So don't be afraid. It's a lot easier than it seems and it definitely pays off tenfold.